just under the wire. In the small Saskatchewan town, spring was always a welcome event. The weather provided that hot-cold combination that made outdoor play comfortable. As summer waited in the wings, families made a special effort to have one more skate or toboggan ride. On one perfect spring day, the boy was sitting on the step in front of his house when his friend's father pulled into the driveway. The friend leaned out of the ranchero window to offer the boy a lift to the creek to go tobogganing. The boy disappeared inside his house to get permission and reappeared wearing his warm clothes and a huge smile. On the way to the creek, they picked up another friend, and the three boys talked excitedly as the father sang along with the radio. On this day, the creek was alive with boys and girls enjoying spring. Most wore water-repellent pants and bulky coats and mitts. Enticed by the warm weather, many kept their hats in their pockets, letting their heads feel the wind for the first time in months. After waiting in line for long periods between tobogganing turns, the boy and his friends grew impatient. They had tobogganed often at the creek near town, and they knew that they were to stay in the designated tobogganing areas. However, just this once, they decided together to break the rules and find a new slope. After serious consideration of many alternatives, they selected a relatively rock-free hill a quarter mile from the public site. There was a small pointed stone ahead and the occasional thin spot, but other than that, the slope was perfect. With no lineup, it wasn't long before they were careening freely down the hill. The boy's larger friend was in first position. Behind him sat the boy, and behind the boy sat their smaller friend. The driver shifted his weight to steer the toboggan past the pointed stone. What they didn't know was that this was the visible peak of a much larger rock. As they tried to miss it, the rock gashed the bottom of the wooden toboggan and tore a partial slat away from beneath the smaller boy's legs. The toboggan tilted as it glided against the side of the big rock, veered dramatically, and began its descent in another direction. They were now bouncing down the rocky side of the hill. This, they knew, was not good. Snow pushed through the hole created by the missing slat and was piling up between the smaller boy's legs. It was obvious that this ride was out of their control as they bounced violently from rock to rock. They realized that they couldn't stop the toboggan with their hands, and jumping off was not an option. At the bottom of the hill, fencing off a 4-foot drop to the road, was a barbed wire fence. They were heading straight toward it. The larger friend in front let out a panicked wail. Instinctively, the friend leaned back, pushing the boy flat. As the boy was crushed by his friend, everything became dark for a second, and then he felt himself slide back, pushing their smaller friend completely off the toboggan. The bigger friend closed his eyes as they went under the barbed wire fence. They careened through the air over the 4-foot drop and flew safely over the much-traveled road and the snow-covered grasses that bordered the valley. Dazed, they landed upright on the frozen creek. As they reluctantly opened their eyes, they realized that they were uninjured. They began to laugh the tentative, nervous laughs of those who feel they have just escaped with their lives. As relief swept over them, they relaxed. They began to wonder about their smaller friend. An eerie creaking sound warned the boys that beneath them everything was not as it should be. All around their toboggan, the frozen creek began to sag, allowing water to seep onto the creek's surface. Then the ice that held them gave away completely, and they sank slowly into the 2 feet of water that filled the creek. Initially unable to move, they soon reacted to the icy water that seeped through their clothes. Reflexes powered their quick jump onto more solid ice. From this more secure position, they worked together to free the toboggan from the creek's grip. Soaking wet, shivering with cold, and amazed at the experiences of the day, they looked earnestly around for cars that might be going back to town. Finally, a neighbor offered the miserable boys a lift. The smaller friend had experienced quite a bump when he fell off the toboggan, but he was dry and without cuts. He willingly pulled the toboggan for his wet and trembling friends. All three climbed gratefully into the offered transportation and rode quietly back to town. Their thoughts drifted toward warm blankets, hot cocoa, and supper. Later, Sitting on the hot air vent in dry clothes and smelling the roast beef his mother was preparing for dinner, the boy felt safe and content. The adventures of the day began to transform themselves from terrifying to tremendous as he allowed the story to take shape in his mind. The tale would soon be ready for sharing with others. I thought this experience might have taught my husband that rules are usually in place for good reasons. When I asked him what he learned on this day, he said, "You can plan all you want, but during the rocky patches, you've just got to hold on and enjoy the ride. You can't always control where you're going to end up."